Keep away from the rock rocks to
What is good, YouTube? It's my final Saturday wedding of the season. I'm about to hit the road, and it's about a 54-minute drive. Ceremony, cocktail hour, and reception. As you can see, the hoodies have arrived. It's hoodie season. The leaves are all changing colors. So I figured I would get the team hoodies. I've got a hoodie right here for Tristan. Mackenzie's got a hoodie. Everyone's got a hoodie. Everyone's got a polo. So perks of the job. We're about to hit up our off season. We've got some fun things coming up, some company training, some MC workshops. We've got a wedding expo, a bridal expo coming up. So super excited. I'll let you guys know all about it in the next videos, and super fun pro tip at the end of this video. So make sure you stick around to the end, drop a like, drop a subscription if you enjoy my content.
Isn't that so cute?
The dog is the family napkin. Or the family dog is the napkin. Wow.
And Tristan goes, I hate that so much.
Tristan said he hates this. I snuck a Maui 5-Go in this corner just so I could kind of fill this room, because I'm not exactly in visibility or in line of sight. So I have a ETX 12P, ETX 18SP. And then I put my mic up on top so that way hopefully can reach over to the head table. And then I've got my hoardboard in here. This is our dance floor for the night. So this should be a nice wedding. We got a 90-person wedding, and the vibes in here are pretty cool. Lots of plants, lots of greenery, lots of disco balls, fall colors. This is a separate room for our photo booth this evening. We're doing the Love Is So Fetch neon backdrop sign. We do have some props. These are our props for the night. This is the photo booth. We're using the Mobi Booth Aura with a 12.9-inch iPad Pro. This also photo booth app. This is our cocktail hour area. They've got a pool table here, which is a first. I haven't seen a pool table in a cocktail hour set up yet. And then it looks like they also have like shuffleboard over here. It's very like relaxing, very chill vibes. Definitely makes me feel like comfortable, like I should have a cigar in my hand or something, you know, like a big old fat one. For our ceremony setup, we have another Maui 5-Go. We've got them in white, and then we're just running a female XLR to quarter inch cable to my Maui to the mic input, so I get extra gain out of it. And then we have our iPad to run our ceremony music. It's battery powered, so you can come back here and you can check to see how much battery you have that's fully charged. And then the Halo Bolt is powering my Shure BLX dual mic receiver transmitter, et cetera, et cetera. And then we were kind of in the sun, so we saw this umbrella here, and we just decided to open it. So we did that. And then Mackenzie's hiding in the back. So for cocktail hour, the couple sent me a playlist, and we're gonna go with Feel Good right here, and we're just gonna hit play on it. And then we raise the left channel up a bit, and then we add our music source a bit, and then we go. There we go. So if it's coming through Rev 7, and I'm playing my Spotify, and if I'm connected to my Rev 7, it will come right through channel number 1. So I just have to make sure I pause this track, and the audio will come right through for cocktail hour. On YouTube, make sure you guys stick around to the end of the video for a big pro tip. You do not want to miss this.
Great memory, and that's great for Sam. Number six, when one has started a new true crime documentary without the other, they'll elect to start it again, no problem. Which is more than I can say for my husband of 5 years. They take very nice pictures together. In fact, we'd love it if you all took out your phones now.
Okay, Okay, so if you made it this far in the video, I know I promised you guys a pro tip, and here it is. This is how I make all my music crates super easily, within minutes actually. I use this app called Crate Hackers, and I'll show you guys my favorite feature is actually the Spotify import feature, because a lot of my couples just send me a Spotify list. So if I click that, paste their Spotify link here, and then what it does is it turns their playlist into a crate, and it'll scan my hard drive of all my music, and it'll tell me which versions of the songs I have, and I can just check the boxes that, you know, I like. So say I like that clean version right there, I'll just leave that. Select the versions that I want, you know, during cocktail hour or ceremony, I'm gonna just want the clean or the original version, the radio version, the single version, not the intro edit. But for dance time, I know I'm gonna be mixing music, so a lot of times, you know, maybe I'll hit like a redrum edit or an intro edit, stuff like that. This also has a bunch of pre-made crates, so, you know, if you're struggling with motivation, you can come in here and you can type in, you know, like wedding and get some ideas for wedding crates or different things that you wanna do. I'll let you guys look more into Crate Hackers. I'm not going to do an entire breakdown of it, but I just wanted to let you guys know that this platform exists if you don't already know about it. And you guys should definitely check it out because it's how I make all my crates different. But this is what I like them to look like. You know, formalities, dancing, ceremony, and then at the end of the gig, I'll take a log of all the songs I played and just throw that in a folder. So that's kind of how I organize things. I'm working on improving it for next year. But yeah, that's my little pro tip. Use Crate Hackers. It'll save you a lot of time.